In this particular session, I'm going to show you how to configure Tomcat server in Eclipse. Basically, Tomcat server or Java server, web browsing, any kind of server, doesn't matter. The same steps, whatever the steps I'm doing right now for Tomcat, the same steps will be applicable. Where you can configure your server for Eclipse and you can run the programs directly in Eclipse. You don't need to create the program in Eclipse and you don't need to run the project separately in server. This is a best way, and even in companies, this will be preferred. How to do that? Let me show it to you right now with practical. First thing, what you need for this is you need to have one particular Eclipse. I'm using Eclipse Kepler over here. You can see Eclipse Kepler over here, and right now Neon is available in the market. You can download that particular thing. Steps wise, same. Even you go for Eclipse, WebLogic, WebSphere, any kind of IDEs which is available. Of course, all the IDEs are derived from Eclipse only. For all those things, parent is Eclipse, so the configuration steps, everything, 99% remains same. Not 99%, 100% you can consider. Fine, this is your Eclipse, and while downloading your Eclipse, you make sure that you will be having Java EE Eclipse. You can let me show it to you. Okay, I'll go to this Eclipse download. Whenever you are downloading, right, IDE for Java EE. IDE for Java developers, don't go for that. Okay, you just click on this. If you go for this one, it will be only for your console based and simple Java programs you can develop it. If you need to develop web applications, that will not be suitable for you. So you don't download this, go for this. It will be for your core Java as well as your advanced Java also. That fine, that is the way you need to download that. And there is no installation, nothing is required for that. Directly you just copy and paste. Next, when it comes to your Apache Tomcat, already I have installed Apache Tomcat. How to install Apache Tomcat, how to set the path, video is available. If you want to have a look, you just look into that particular video also. Okay, this is C drive, program files, Apache Software Foundation. I have installed over here Tomcat 7.0, yes, okay, it is available, it is working fine. Already I have tested in previous video also. If you want, you can have a look into that. Yeah, now no servers are available. This is servers tab. If suppose the tab is not available, you just go to window, show view, here servers, you just add it. You can get that particular window. Sometimes they may not get that window. Okay, click the link and Apache. Yes, 7.0 server, I can configure it over here. Tomcat 7.0, click next. Browse. Okay, C drive. Program files 86, it was there. So get into program files 86, Apache Software Foundation. Tomcat 7.0, yes. Till there, otherwise you can download and install that particular Apache. And you select the JRE. Your installed GRS, it will be picking up. Next, finish. That's it. Your Tomcat server is configured. And some people, they will be expecting, I want to change the port address of the Tomcat in Eclipse. And basically, 8180 will be the port address for your Tomcat. Suppose if you want a different port address for your machine, and if you want different port address for your Eclipse, just straight away click here. You can see the server console. Here you can change the port addresses. Instead of 8105, my machine I have configured it as 8105, you can change it to something else also, 8205, 8280, something like this, any kind of port addresses. Before going to change the port address, you just type netstat. Here it will show you list of the port addresses which are busy, already occupied. So you just don't go with that particular port addresses. still it is loading. So many port addresses are busy in my machine. So local addresses, foreign addresses, everything will be listed out over here. So make sure that we are not using that. Okay, that is one thing. You can change the port addresses over here. Then, okay, that's let it be. Your server folder will be created and your rest of the configurations will be done over here. This is the way. If you want, let me run it for you. It is starting your Tomcat. Yes, Tomcat is started successfully. If you want, you can have a look. Server startup 955 milliseconds. Okay, that's it. This is the way you need to install, I mean, you need to configure Tomcat server into your Eclipse. Even in WebSphere, WebLogic, same steps are applicable because it is derived from Eclipse. Thank you so much.